Hello, so before we get started, I just wanted to point out a few things real quick. So I've wanted to put up these lights since December, because obviously they're Christmas lights, but they've just been sitting in my floor since December, and today is literally March 1st. If that isn't procrastination, I don't know what is. But also, I got a new ring from the aquarium that I wanted to show you. It's a cute little turtle, and it's opal, which I know you're not supposed to wear opals unless your birthday is October or whatever other birthday would be for opal. It's cute, and my mom's opal, so when she eventually isn't here anymore, I want like all of her jewelry, so I will be wearing it being opal. So, whatever. But I also got this cute little thing. Isn't it so cute? It's a little sea otter, and it's holding a starfish. It's so cute. We're gonna go ahead and get on into it. So today we are watching season 2, episode 15, Irresistible, which I did find out, obviously, in editing, it was Indestructible, I think, right? For the Disturb song. So anyway, let's just get on into it.
Who's in the mood for a song?
I think I'll skip the juice. I know what you mean.
Oh my god, this episode!
So Cleo, listen to this.
I honestly had no clue when this episode was gonna happen, but I'm kinda glad it's today, because it's so funny. That guitar is actually really pretty. I love the blue.
So what do you say? You? Me? Your place? First lesson's free.
You wanna give me a guitar lesson?
Yeah, absolutely. Why not? I'm really good at it.
Well, it has been pretty high on my to-do list.
Really?
Yeah. It's up there with getting my fillings replaced.
Oh, I really thought she was gonna humor him for a minute to try to get Lewis jealous.
I had a good time last night.
Yeah, me too.
Maybe we could go out again.
Maybe.
Oh, this is literally a day later from the last episode where they went out to see a movie, I guess.
I've got work to do.
Yeah.
Awkward.
What do you know about something called ambergris?
What's so funny? Ambergris is a myth.
Doesn't exist?
Oh, it exists, though it's very rare.
The internet says...
I love seeing Zane again. I know I'm not gonna like him in season 3, but while I like him, I'm gonna keep liking him.
But it was... All that stuff about his scent supposedly having magical effects over mermaids is rubbish. So, why are you asking?
I go out with a mermaid. I'm interested in this sort of stuff. And if it does have some sort of mesmerizing effect on mermaids, it could be useful in certain situations.
Please give me one example.
I don't know. You could always use it to win Cleo back.
Hey, I've got a new girlfriend. Cleo and I are just history.
No kidding.
Whatever you're thinking, Zane, forget it. Ambergris is a myth.
Everyone knows that Lewis and Zane need to just be together. But I'm glad that Lewis is on the good side of being like, don't want to literally take away their freedom basically by hypnotizing them with the ambergris.
Hey, Cleo. How's it going?
What are you doing here?
Nate's teaching me how to play guitar.
I was so blown away by her enthusiasm. Offered her a free guitar lesson.
Hey, free? You said you'd pay me.
Nate? You said you'd pay me. Oh my gosh.
I want you to get out of my house before I tell Dad you're stalking me.
I am not.
His bangs look so shiny and healthy. Oh my gosh.
You're not what?
Dad, Nate's teaching me how to play guitar.
Is that what that racket was?
Yeah, that's right. Your daughter here is a real natural, Mr. S.
Really? You've been teaching long, Nate?
Huh? Oh, yeah.
Oh.
A week.
You're pretty handy with a guitar.
Oh, yeah, but I don't like to brag, so.
Good. You know what I'm handy with, Nate?
A wrench.
That thing.
How about I teach you about garbage disposal units? Free of charge.
I'm pretty sure this is after Nate got her flowers and said hottest chick, right? So, he definitely already doesn't like
Nate. You alright?
Yeah.
Didn't need that fingernail anyway, did I?
I think your dad likes me. He let me do all the heavy bits.
Let me do all the heavy bits. He was trying to get him to go away. Dave.
Good for you.
So, what are you doing for the rest of the morning, babe?
Oh, showering. Get away, you smell.
Oh, well, I've been working really hard, raising a sweat.
That's not a sweat. You stink. I will never, ever go out with you.
Tons like you, Harder.
So that's a no.
Get on.
Lewis.
Zane.
Lewis. What's up? I found it. Pure ambergris.
How did you find it?
On the internet. A local antique dealer had some. He said it's over 100 years old.
Nowadays, you can find whatever basically on Amazon.
I bought this out of scientific curiosity. You should understand that.
Old. Yuck, it smells like rotten squid.
Well, it is 100 years old and made from whale excrement.
Take it away.
No. Take it. No!
Great. Zane, I'm supposed to be having lunch with Charlotte any minute.
I think you're going to be eating by yourself.
Hey, Lewis. Sorry I'm late. Oh. What is that?
Zane.
You've been gutting fish?
No, it was his fault. He squirted it on me.
Look, I don't care what this is, but if you think I'm having lunch with you smelling like that, forget it.
I mean, I would still have lunch with him because she's already there. They can literally sit outside right there on that table.
Charlotte, come on, I'll have a shower.
I'm actually shocked he's chasing her because normally he like doesn't really care. Like whenever Emma was on her fish gills and swimming in public, cared about them more than Charlotte. Nate actually like it is what I want to know. If it smells like poop and sulfur and like disgusting, and he's like, let me spray some. And look, those people aren't even like really next to him and they're all leaving.
Where are all the customers going?
They're leaving.
Why?
Can you please talk to Nate and convince him to go somewhere else or at least take a bath?
Nate? I'm only gonna say this once. I want you. To never leave my sight. I wanna be with you all the time and do whatever you say.
But you don't think I stink?
Oh no, I think you smell manly and attractive and.
This episode is so funny.
Hi, Cleo. Two more, please, Ash.
And what's going on?
Just between you and me. I think love is in the air. It's like I'm seeing Nate with new eyes.
That really sucks for Ash, though, because they just went on a date, and now she's, like, crushing on Nate. Ugh. Gross.
Get it. Emma can't stand Nate. None of us can. Something's not right.
Your eyes are so pretty.
Hey, Nate. You look good today. Mind if I join you?
Sure.
What are you talking about?
Nothing.
I'm letting him look at me.
Can I do that too?
Sure.
Okay, Ash should really know there's something weird is going on because Cleo just said none of us can stand him.
Where is that bottle?
I don't know. I think it's back on that table.
Why? You're not having second thoughts, are you?
No. I just want to take a closer look, maybe analyze a sample.
Sure you do.
Once and for all, Charlotte and I are happy together. Cleo is not in the picture. Since when do you care?
Just heard some talk.
What do you mean? What have you heard?
Nothing.
What have you heard? Is Charlotte...
Hey,
not
Zane,
Charlotte.
Wait up. What have you heard?
He really wants to know if Cleo is still talking about him. That's so cute. I mean, not cute. He has a girlfriend, but I want him to be with Cleo.
Hey, muchacho. Whatever you got to say to me, you can say right here in front of these fine feminitos. We're all friends, right?
Okay. Nate, you stink. You've driven out all my customers.
You're just jealous.
What?
Hey, the girl's perceptive.
Emma, look at this place. It's empty.
And how is that Nate's fault?
Because he smells like a tuna with hygiene issues.
What's going
on? I mean, I'm sure he is jealous, but it's not just about that.
Let's ask Ricky, shall we?
That's not a fair judge. She's also a mermaid.
Hey, Ricky. Does Nate stink?
Are you kidding?
Nate's the most... He's just the most man I've ever met.
Here's a fun fact in case y'all didn't know it. Apparently, Ricky and Nate were actually dating in real life. I'm not sure if it was during the show filming or if it was after. But that would be really hard to be dating a friend of the person that you're pretending to date in the show.
It's the last thing I need is more girlfriend problems.
Took the words right out of my mouth.
Hey, Ash, did you see a little bottle on this table?
No.
Great, now it's lost.
You know, I'll never understand women. I go out with Emma once, we have a great time, and the next time we meet, it's like I don't even exist.
Huh?
I think this whole sensitive guy thing doesn't work. I mean, look at Nate. The guy has no brains, no sensitivity, and he's surrounded.
What?
Emma's all over him in the juice bar. And Ricky. And Cleo.
What, Nate?
It's like they're mesmerized.
See, he obviously still wants Cleo or else he wouldn't care. He's laughing that Ricky was part of it, but once he said Cleo, he's like, what? The guitar is so pretty. I love watching Ricky specifically on this part.
But you know what this is, don't you? The ambergris.
No, what, you figured that out all by yourself?
Well, Mr. Ambergris is a myth.
What are we gonna do?
How can she touch him, let alone dance for him?
Ricky?
What?
Can you come outside for a sec?
I'm dancing with Nate.
Yeah, I can see that. Don't you think it's a little strange?
It sounds hot.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, buddy. This is why I like watching Ricky, her walking with her little feet. It's just so funny.
Really need your help, man. Trouble with the Zodiac, and you're the ace with boats.
I'm a bit busy here, mate.
Yeah, I know, and I wouldn't ask if it wasn't an emergency. Well,
I guess I could spare 5 minutes. You'll wait, won't you, ladies?
Don't go, please.
Allow me a second.
Why don't we just hook up at the beach later on? Now I can give you all my attention.
Promise. Lewis's
face. Bye. That was perfect.
Ciao, Natey.
Perfect.
Okay, Nate, hand it over.
What?
Don't try the dumb act.
It's not a dumb act.
Would you just give me my bottle?
They added that part after of Zane saying, will you just give me my bottle? I can hear it in my earbuds that it was different.
Why else do you think Ricky would be all over you?
So that's what this is all about. This. Well, this.
Ew, stop it.
Has nothing to do with it.
Push him in the water.
The girls have finally come to their senses and hopped on board the Nate train, and you guys are just jealous.
The Nate train?
The Nate train.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. Listen, the reason the girls dig the Nate is because he's a guitar-playing, karate-chopping, big-wave-surfing love machine. Face it, guys, you're just outgunned.
They should have pushed him in the water.
What time is it? It's 2:00 already. What have we been doing all day?
Emma, can I speak to you, please? And maybe you'd like to explain things.
Ash. What things?
Like what you were doing in there?
I was on my lunch break.
Do you have to be so blatant about it?
You want me to hide during lunch?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe a bit of warning would have been nice, that's all.
Ash, I take lunch at the same time every day.
Emma, you know what I'm talking about, and if you want to play games...
I feel so bad for Emma because it's like a full moon. She doesn't have a clue.
Tell me about how you got such a great body.
Yeah.
Did you miss me?
Yup.
Who missed me the most?
Me. Me?
No, I did. Oh, girls. Come on, let's not fight. There's plenty of Nate to go around. Who's up for a swim?
Me.
Ricky is just so cute. I love her. She's the most like, oh my God, love me, look at me. And it's just so cute because it's like the furthest from her personality.
Emma didn't tell you where she was going?
She doesn't tell me anything.
Come on, you must have seen where they went.
Oh, towards the beach.
And he doesn't know how dangerous that is, especially with Nate. Because he would be the stupid one to actually go tell people or try to expose them or something.
Hey! So you don't want to go and get your swimsuits?
We don't want to leave you.
Oh, I know the feeling. Hey, first one to swim out to that buoy and back gets to kiss me.
That's so dangerous, swimming out to the buoy in clothes.
With us right now, or you're going to regret this.
Hey! You guys really need to get over this whole jealousy thing and face the facts. The girls jumped for the Nateroo, don't you, ladies?
What are we doing? Why am I here? Zane, what's going on?
It's hard to explain, but you've been attracted to Nate. You all have.
Go swim quick.
That's more like it.
Nate thinks he won the girls. That's so funny.
Nate, if you actually think they like you, you really are an idiot. If I didn't have three beautiful ladies waiting for me, I'd...
They're leaving without you.
Girl?
And they don't want to have to explain it, so they're just walking away like, bye!
Who would have thought? A few drops of this stinky stuff.
Don't worry.
We're looking after this very carefully from now on.
Well, you want to keep it?
We know it works now. A few drops of this could...
solve all your problems with Cleo.
Don't try and bring me down to your level.
No, see, there's not problems with Cleo, though, because she still likes him.
We are just friends.
And you're not the least bit tempted? You could have her falling at your feet.
She even hung out with him to get the live bait and said, yeah, we should do this again. It was fun.
Why would you want someone who does everything you want, but not because they want to?
Lewis, here you are. Looking everywhere for you. You're not still playing with that bottle of stench, are you?
Not anymore.
Him pouring this out in front of Charlotte is kind of like him choosing Charlotte over Cleo, which I know he kind of does because he's in a relationship with Charlotte, but he probably secretly hated that he did that after.
Oh no, that's why Ash was acting so weird. What did I do in front of him? Everything okay?
Well, yeah, business is booming now that your stinky friend has moved on.
Yeah, about that, it's kind of hard to explain.
Seemed quite obvious to me. Is he an old boyfriend or something?
Not really.
No, they hate him.
We've just known each other a long time.
Is that how you behave around all your old friends?
No.
No.
Sorry, can we start again?
Are there any other weird things in your past I should know about?
No.
I mean, yeah, because honestly, the weirdest thing is that she's a mermaid, and he doesn't need to know that yet. It's too early. So that was episode... 15, Irresistible. And the next one is season 2, episode 16, Double Trouble. And based off the thumbnail, I do remember it. Oops, I made this fall in Charlotte. I do remember it, and I've honestly been waiting for this next episode because I remember it and I like it a lot. It might make me a little happy. So yeah, I can't wait for that. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and let me know what you think of the light behind me. Oh, and I forgot to point out this cute little mushroom thing. It also does rain water, but for the video, obviously, I didn't want that sound going on, so the color's gonna change in the background. I think it's cool, and I like my light over there in the background as well, but anyway, yeah, now I gotta get up and move Charlotte, so... You can't see her. Pretty. Okay, bye.